We're learning more about a fake active shooter call Boulder police were forced to respond to.
This exclusive body camera video showing police rushing inside of that liquor store. Our Nicole Fierro is speaking to Boulder police officers about the threat. A story you'll see only here on FOX 31.
Yeah, these officers here rushing to the liquor store are the same officers that responded to the Boulder King Soopers mass shooting and lost a fellow officer to an active shooter. So while this call ended up being fake, you really see here firsthand that a threat like this, it's not taken lightly, and a 46-year-old woman is now facing big consequences for this threat. Saturday night, at least 25 Boulder police officers fleeing from briefing, running, rushing to Hazel's Beverage World.
All on-duty personnel responded. We were there in about 2 minutes.
An emergency response.
Somebody came in with an assault rifle, yeah?
Where's the bathroom?
To an emergency 911 call.
That there was someone that had entered Hazel's store with what was described as an assault rifle with a mask on and had gone back into the restroom. When we get that kind of call, we obviously have to treat it like this person is going in there to do the worst intention.
We see active shooter training.
Put into action.
Who's on me?
I'm on you right here. Give me somebody with less lethal. Let's get a shield.
They're basically putting a physical barrier between the bathroom and any employees that are still there, grabbing shield, long guns, all the things that will help us enter that building and safely end a threat.
This is the Boulder Police Department.
A threat.
If you are in the women's bathroom, make yourself known right now.
Ending up being fake.
We figured out this person had been in the store earlier and had some sort of vendetta with the store for being asked to leave multiple times.
A decision with legal consequences for the suspect, emotional ones for the community and department forced in the middle.
It's a call that comes out when you know it's likely community members are being harmed or killed. We're going to get there very quickly, and so that puts our officers at risk just responding. It puts the community at risk just by that emergency response.
Yeah, they traced the call and tracked down a 46-year-old woman allegedly behind the fake threat. She's now being charged with a felony for false reporting of explosives. If convicted this type of felony, it could come with a 12 to 18-month jail time and fines between $1,000 to $100,000. Reporting live here in studio, Nicole Fierro, FOX 31. All right.